Greetings to all my dear friends and followers of the Blue Cube YouTube channel. I am Arash Adder, and this is the first lesson of the Adobe Animate software training course from 0 to 100 that I am at your service. In this video, you will get acquainted with the software environment, creating a new document, and also document settings. Before starting the training, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, be sure to click the subscribe button below the video and like the video. When you open Adobe Animate software for the first time, this window will appear for you. On the left is the open option, which when you click on it, you can easily select the projects you have previously saved from your computer drive and click the open option. Okay, I'm closing this for now. Above the open option is the create new option. If you click on it, the new document window will open for us, where we can create a new document for ourselves. Now, what is a document? If you have seen Photoshop and Illustrator software on my educational channel before, you are completely familiar with documents. But if you have not, I must tell you that documents are like sheets of paper on which we design and execute our designs and animations. Now, these documents or papers that I mentioned have different friend sizes for different tasks. We need different sizes. Here, too, if you pay attention, it is written preset. These documents with different sizes are also called presets, which now show us four presets. We can choose full HD, HD, 4K documents and different modes here for our work. For example, if we want to use them for Instagram, Telegram, or Facebook and social networks, there are different sizes here. Click on each of them to see their width and height written in this section. For example, if I choose this preset for Facebook, you see that its width is 600 pixels and its height is 315 pixels. There are a lot of them. We can choose the preset based on our needs. There are also other presets in the game section. There are also options and presets in the educational advertising web and other mode sections. Here I select the character animation section and choose the HD preset for my work, which has a value of 1280 by 720. In fact, a height of 720 and a width of 1280 pixels. In the unit section, which is currently disabled for us, we can choose the unit of measurement, which we will discuss later. It is disabled for us here, and a very important point that my friends should definitely keep in mind is the frame rate option. Note that frame rate is the number of frames that are displayed to us in 1 second. Each frame is an image that appears together to create movement. That is, when we say that this animation or the preset that we have chosen is 30 frames per second, it means that there are 30 frames or images in 1 second. Just keep these in mind, my friends, that when we work with them, you will fully understand later and will be reminded for you. Now, for the time being, just theoretically keep in mind what I am saying. Now, the higher the frame rate of an animation, the smoother the movement will be, and the lower it is, the animation will be slower or choppy. Now, how do we know how much the frame rate should be? For example, for animations that we make for social networks such as Instagram or Telegram, these 30 frames per second are suitable. For example, 24 frames are used for cinema films. Or if you choose the web, you see that its frame rate is 24. For some games, I also consider 30 to 60 frames because it requires a higher frame rate. Finally, my friends, I choose these 30 frames per second, the HD mode, and in the type platform section, I choose the same action script option. And I click on the create option here to create the preset for me, and a new document is also created. But friends, if you pay attention in this section, these documents and presets also exist exactly. We could easily click here and create a document and a preset for us very quickly, and from here you can quickly come and select your document. I click on the create option here to create a new document for me. So here's our document that has now been created, and we can run our designs and animations on this document. At the top, if you pay attention, my friends, there are menus that we can choose from in future lessons, and we will review their options together. On the left side of the software, there are various tools that we will learn all of them in the following tutorials. We can click here to completely close the tools and click on this arrow again to make the tools appear for me. Here is our document. You can see the document we have chosen. For example, in the file section, I can create a new document again and click on create to create a new document. Now we have two documents and we can work on each of them separately. I will delete the second document for now. At the bottom, my friends, there is a timeline where we will create our animations. We can come from this section and zoom into the timeline like this. Zoom in or out. Here is the play option and the other options that we will discuss in future lessons. If you pay attention to frame 60, it shows second 2. The timeline continues in this way. If you pay attention, these are our frames. If I make this bigger, these are our frames, and since we have chosen 30 frames per second, if you pay attention here, after 30 frames, it is written 1 second above. So every 30 frames is 1 second. If you pay attention to frame 60, it shows second 2. The timeline continues in this way. My friends, you can move around the software environment using these levers. Move left or right like this. You can also move up or down like this. For example, if you exit that environment, you can easily click this option to quickly return to the previous state. Click the center stage option and quickly return to your previous state. Sometimes, my friends, we need to rotate the artboard for our design. Using this option, which is the rotation tool, select it, hold down the left mouse button, and move the artboard like this. Again, to return the artboard to its previous state, simply click on this center stage option to return the artboard to its original state. If I select one of the tools, that point is also deleted. There are also a few panels on the right side of the software environment, my friends. If I select assets, you can see that there are a number of characters here that we can download and use. We will discuss them in the future. Here is the properties panel where we can change the settings of documents and objects. Here is the color section. We can change the colors. We change the color of objects and shapes. We use the align menu to align the shape on the document or align the shape. And finally, there is the library option, which we will use later. But friends, if I go back to the properties panel and select it here, it says doc in the document section, which is an abbreviation for our document. My friends, we can change the color of the document from here. For example, click here and place the mouse on any of these colors. The color of the artboard changes for us. For example, if I click here, the color of my artboard now turns yellow. I click on it again and choose the color white for it. We can also change the length and width of the document here. If I hold down the left mouse button and drag here, I have made the document much smaller. If I press Ctrl plus Z, my document returns to its previous state. So pressing Ctrl plus Z takes you one step back and pressing Ctrl plus Y takes you one step forward. If you click on the Edit menu or menu, it says Ctrl plus Z goes back and Ctrl plus Y takes you one step forward. We will continue working on this and you will fully understand. Now, my friends, when we want to change one of these like this, you see that this height does not change. We can only change the width like this. But if I press Ctrl plus Z again and return to the previous state, activate the Scale Content option. If I change the width or height like this, the height changes automatically and in fact the changes are proportional to the width and length like this for us. Both the length and width change and in fact it does not spoil our artboard shape. I'll press Ctrl plus Z a few times to get back to my previous state. 1280 by 720. I will also click on this option so that I can see my share in full. Now, my friends, if I reduce the zoom amount a bit, that is, I get farther away like here, 50% mode, and if I select it, you will see that we have gone a little farther and we can also look around the artboard. If I click on this option, you can see that the entire surroundings of my document also turn white and I can place the designs wherever I want. But remember, what we ultimately output is within this framework. Okay, I'll deactivate it for now. The next option, my friends, is FPS, which is actually the frame rate, which I explained to you when I wanted to create a document at the beginning of the video. It is shown to us here as FPS and is set to 30, which means that 1 second is made up of 30 frames. I can also change the value and set it to 24 like this. If you look at the timeline, 1 second is now equal to 24 frames, which is also written here. I can go back and select 30 for it. Now, my friends, if I press the play button, you see that it has changed and now every 30 frames is 1 second. So whenever you change the frame rate or FPS value, you can see it here as well. Okay, I'm deactivating it for now. Now, my friends, when you change the zoom level from here, for example, I can select the fit in window mode to see the entire document. Or I can zoom in a lot. Whenever you make changes to the zoom and want to quickly go back to the previous state, you can press Ctrl+1 to quickly see your entire artboard. Again, my friends, in the properties window, we can, for example, activate the ruler. We can activate the snap to object mode, which we use for the adhesion of shapes in the artboard. You can also use this option to create adhesion in guides and lines. Activate and deactivate it, and we can lock the guides, which I will explain to you in full detail later. I just want to introduce you to it now. You can see that the other panels in the properties window are inactive. Why are they inactive? Because we haven't selected any tools yet, so that the tools section is activated. If I click here, the tools section is activated, and if I create a shape, for example, like this and select it, you see that the object panel opens for me. And I can make changes here and change the color of my shape like this. So whatever tool or shape we select, the corresponding section in the properties panel is activated for us. Then, my friends, finally, this software like Photoshop in the window section, if you go and select Workspace, you see that it has classic and animator modes and different modes. Choose any of them. The windows will change for you in this way. You can also change these according to the work you need to do. For example, if I select the classic mode, it changes like this. You can also change the workspaces from here. For example, I will select the basic mode for it to return to the previous state. You can also change the windows again, my friends. For example, let's come here and make the timeline bigger. Drag and separate each of these sections. You can also activate the different panels that we need in the window section. Now, if you have messed up the different panels like this, you can quickly restore them to their previous state and go to the window section, workspace, and click on the reset option. Now that I click and press the yes button, you see that all the settings of my working environment return to their previous state. Okay, my friends, I won't make this tutorial too long. You can watch the rest of the lesson in the next video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I would really appreciate it if you haven't subscribed yet. Be sure to practice and memorize everything until the next video. Goodbye for now.